Welcome and good morning to all BSc second year students of Physical Science. Students, during last part we are studying various aspects of sexual dimorphism in fishes. The character which is to be related to the sexual dimorphic characters or the secondary sexual characters. In this point, we have continued today again sexual dimorphism in fishes. During last part, we have seen sexual dimorphism in Scolidon and sexual dimorphism in Holocephali, that is Chimera. Then today, we have seen remaining fishes or remaining classes in which sexual dimorphism is to be found, sexual dimorphism is to be seen. Among these, first in a teleostomy is the modern class, recent class and developed recently. Hence this class is the most important class in fishes. In teleostomy, fertilization is generally external in water, but in few species, a copulative organ is present in the male and internal fertilization takes place. In some species of teleostomy, the copulative organ is to be present and this copulative organ is to be used for the internal fertilization in these teleostomy members or the freshwater fishes. A very simple condition is to be seen in the catfish. Very simple condition is to be seen in catfish, especially in Mr. Singhala. In this Mr. Singhala species, a special character these are to be seen, in which a conical genital papilla is present in the male fish in Mr. Singhala, and this papilla is to be conical genital papilla is present, and that conical genital papilla is only present in male Mr. Singhala, whereas such conical papilla is to be absent in female Mr. Singhala. Depending on these papilla or the genital papilla, we can recognize the fishes male Mr. Singhala and fishes female Mr. Singhala. Depending on this character, we can recognize the species, either male or female. In Gambusia affinis, fossa difference extends as a tube up to the end of anterior ray of the anal fin. In Gambusia affinis, the fossa difference extends as a tube up to the end of anterior rays of the anal fin, which are modified to form an elongated tubular grooved copulatory organ, and it is to be called as gonopodium. This gonopodium is to be present only in male Gambusia affinis, and this gonopodium is to be absent in the female Gambusia affinis. What is the sexual dimorphic character in Gambusia affinis? A Gambusia affinis, the fossa difference extends as a tube up to the end of the anterior ray of the anal fin, and this fossa difference, these are to be modified to form a tubular grooved long structure, and this tubular long grooved structure is called as gonopodium. These are to be used at the time of copulation, at the time of mating, and with the help of gonopodium, male these are to be transfer their sperm inside the female's body. That's why this gonopodium is present in male guppy fish and this gonopodium is to be absent in the female guppy fish. Female Gambusia is larger than male Gambusia. No any male Gambusia is similar color. Most variations in color is made In male Gambusia finish, which is to be found, male fish has various colors of body. Male fish has various colors of body. Such various colors, these are to be not found in the female Gambusia finish. Means when we have compared, when we have see different male Gambusia, then these different Gambusia, these are to be different to each other, different to one another. Because similar color, these are to be not present in male Gambusia. Color variation, these are to be found, color variation, these are to be occur in the Gambusia fish. And male fish have various colors of the body, various colors, and this gonopodium is to be absent in female Gambusia and present in male Gambusia. Depending on this gonopodium, we can identify whether the fish is to be male or whether the fish is to be female. Hence, guppy fish is called as rainbow fish due to the color formation, due to the varied color structure. Because in Gambusia finis, males, these are to be different color sets, different colors. No same male color which is to be found in other fish or another male fish, because it is to be color variation. Hence, Gambusia finis or guppy fish is called as rainbow fish, which is to be seen, which is to be found in this figure. See, in this figure, as compared to see that, these two figures, these two fishes, these are to be seen, these are to be found. Which are these two fishes? First, upper fish, in this fish, male Gambusia finish. This is the gonopodium, which is the gonopodium I have coated in red color. Just behind, it is long, tubular, elongated structure, these are to be developed. Structure, these are to be developed just on the ventral side in front of the pelvic fin. And that structure, elongated, long, tubular structure, it is called as gonopodium. This gonopodium is to be present in male Gambusia affinis, whereas this gonopodium is absent in female Gambusia affinis. See, this is the lower figure, is the male Gambusia, upper figure, and lower is the female Gambusia. What is the difference between these two figures? First figure, it is to be small, gonopodium is to be present, which is to be indicated in green red circle, whereas lower figure, where is to be coated as green border, this figure fish is the female Gambusia affinis. This female Gambusia is to be affinis is larger, whereas male Gambusia is to be smaller. Gonopodium is present in male Gambusia and gonopodium is to be absent in the female Gambusia. Depending on this character, we can identify whether the guppy fish is male fish or female fish, which is to be seen in this figure. Yes, clearly this is the gonopodium, whereas this is the female fish, there is absence of gonopodium. This structure identify the male fish and female fish. See, again, these are the male guppy fish, these are the female guppy fish, this is the male guppy fish, whereas male guppy fish, red color, then pink color is the female guppy fish, then again, blue color, again it is the this male guppy fish, where is the gonopodium is present in blue circle, and again yellow color, it is the female Gambusia. Means these guppy fish, male guppy and female guppy. Male guppy, these are to be, color is to be variable, color these are to be different in male fish. See, this guppy fish as well as this male guppy fish. Both these males, these are to be different colors. That's why it is a color variation, these are to be seen, these are to be. And females, these are to be larger. Female, these are to be larger as compared to the male. But in female, gonopodium is absent, and this gonopodium, these are to be useful at the time of copulation. This gonopodium, these are to be inserted into the female's genital opening, and it introduces the sperm, and then fertilization, these are to be takes place. Depending on this character, we can identify. Next example, in the cyprinoid fish, Xenodexia, in this fish, see, this is the genodexia fish, which is to be indicated yellow color. Yes, in the cyprinodont fish genodexia, the pectoral fin are modified and are used for holding the gonopodium, in position for the insertion into the oviduct of the female fish. Such pectoral fin these are to be formed, and this pectoral fin these are to be developed, these are to be formed in the genodexia cyprinodont fish, and this pectoral fin these are to be modified and forms holding the gonopodium in position for insertion into the oviduct of the female fish. Such gonopodium is absent in female genodexia. This gonopodium is the sexual dimorphic character only found in male genodexia fish. This gonopodium is to present. This gonopodium is to be only found in male genodexia, whereas it is to be absent in female genodexia. It is another example to identify the sexual dimorphic character. Means these are to be related for the copulation, these are to be related for the reproduction. Then second criteria, second category, the structures. Second category, these are to be seen, these are to be studied. And that second category is the structures not related with copulation. There is no relation between copulation and structure which is to present on male fish or female fish. But these structures, these are to present in one fish, whereas it is to be absent in another fish. Well-marked structural differences are seen. Well-marked structural differences are found in two sexes in same species. Two sexes in same species, especially during the breeding season. These are not related with copulation. During breeding season, during a spawning season, such structure these are to present, these are to be found in the same sexes in some fishes, in some species. Which are these structure? In most of the teleosts, the female is larger in size than the male. In most of the teleosts, female is larger than the male. A large fleshy hump is seen. A large fleshy hump is seen on the head of the male lionhead cichlid fish. A large fleshy knob-like, bulb-like structure is to be seen on head of the male lionhead cichlid fish. In this fish, on head region, a large fleshy hump is to be seen. Such large fleshy hump is not seen on the head of the female lionhead cichlid fish. Such structure is to be not seen in the male lionhead cichlid. This fleshy hump is not related to the sexual dimorphic character, but it differentiates the male fish and the female fish. On this structure, we can identify, we can recognize whether male lionhead or fish is to be female lionhead. Means such large fleshy hump is to be seen in only male lionhead cichlid fish, whereas it is to be absent in female lionhead cichlid fish, which is to be have seen. Here, see the figure, male lionhead cichlid fish showing large fleshy hump on head. See, this is the upper, this figure is to be indicated, this is the female lionhead cichlid fish, and below green color it is the male lionhead cichlid fish. What is the structure? This is the large fleshy hump which is to be coated, which is to be colored by green color. Yes, such large fleshy hump is to be only present in male lionhead cichlid fish, which is to be present in male lionhead cichlid fish, and it is to be absent in the female lionhead cichlid fish. Females are larger and males are smaller. Here I have draw the figure to indicate and to understand a complete figure. That's why it is to be look like larger as compared to the female fish. But originally female these are to be larger and males are smaller. Here we have only see this large fleshy hump is to be seen on the male lionhead cichlid head, and which is to be absent on the female. Depending on this, we can identify, recognize the fish as a male fish or female fish. See, Male lion head chichlid showing large fleshy hump on head which is absent in female fish. This is the fish. This is the male lion head chichlid fish. On this male lion head chichlid fish, this is the large fleshy hump. Knob-like structure, bulb-like structure is to present, and this structure is to be related to not reproduction, but it is to be present in male fish and it is to be absent in female fish. This character or this structure we can identify on this identification structure whether the lion head is to be female lion head or whether the lion head is to be male lion head. We can recognize, we can identify the fish is male fish and female fish. In some teleosts, as in swordtail fish, in some other teleosts, as in swordtail fish. Swordtail fish, scientific name of swordtail fish is Zippophorus hilleri. Remember that. What is the scientific name of this swordtail fish? This is the swordtail fish called as a Zippophorus hilleri. Remember that. It is to be asked in MCQ. It is to be asked in MCQ. What is the scientific name of swordtail fish? Zippophorus hilleri, or Zippophorus hilleri is commonly called as swordtail fish. In this swordtail fish, or in this Zippophorus hilleri, the lower lobe of caudal fin is elongated in male swordtail fish so as to form a blade-like structure, pointed blade-like structure. These are to be present, and this pointed blade-like structure as a sword, pointed blade-like structure as a sword, such blade-like, sword-like structure is to be absent in male swordfish. In male, female swordfish, in male swordtail fish, caudal peduncle is broad, both lobes of caudal fin is pointed, but lower lobe is to be elongated and drawn into a sword-like structure, hence it is called as a swordtail fish. Such a sword-like structure, such blade-like structure is to be not found, not seen in female swordtail fish. And this is the sexual dimorphic character found in the Zippophorus hilleri. Such a structure is to be found in Zippophorus hilleri or the swordtail fish, and we can recognize, we can identify whether the fish is male fish or whether the fish is to be female fish, which is to be shown, which is to be seen in the below figure. Yes, see the figure. This is the most peculiar and interesting color of the fish, that is the swordtail fish. Sexual dimorphism in male and female swordtail fish is to be seen, is to be observed. See, upper fish is the upper fish. Yes, this is the male fish, and lower fish, it is the female fish. In this female fish, such pointed blade-like structure, see, this is pointed blade-like structure, that is lower lobe of caudal fin, these are to be modified, these are to be formed a blade-like structure, a sword-like structure, and structure, such structure is to be not present in female fish. Hence, this structure, these are to be recognized, identified, whether Zippophorus hilleri is to be male or whether Zippophorus hilleri is to be female. This is the good and well-marked sexual dimorphism which is to be seen in the this Zippophorus hilleri. Again, blade-like structure present in male Zippophorus hilleri, which is to be seen, which is to be found. Females are larger, males are smaller, and to the caudal, lower lobe of this caudal fin, these are to be modified and forms a such blade-like structure, and this such blade-like structure is to be seen, is to be occur. This is the swordtail, which is to present in male fish, whereas it is to be absent in this female fish. Female is larger and male is to be smaller. Such structure is to be found, such structure is to be occur. In another teleost fish, hippocampus is commonly known as seahorse. Another teleost fish is the hippocampus, and hippocampus is commonly known as seahorse. It is also asked for MCQ. What is the scientific name of seahorse? Scientific name of seahorse is hippocampus. In this fish, it possesses the sexual dimorphic character, as the male seahorse possesses a brood pouch on the abdomen. male seahorse, male hippocampus possesses a brood pouch on the abdomen, whereas in female hippocampus such brood pouch is absent. Depending on this brood pouch, we can identify the fish is male hippocampus and fish is female hippocampus. In this brood pouch, male hippocampus fish lay the eggs, and these are to be incubated by male inside the brood pouch. After incubation, young ones are developed, and this brood pouch is used as a shelter for young ones. This brood pouch is the best example for parental care also. Not only female they can take, care of eggs or offspring, but in fishes also some male can take parental care, take a care of their offspring, and it is the good example, famous example, that is brood pouch is to be present in male fish and brood pouch is to be absent in female fish. At the time of copulation, female these are to be deposit the egg inside the brood chamber, then male insert their sperms and eggs, these are to be incubate, inside the brood pouch, and then after egg hatching, small spawn fry these are to be developed, and these spawn fry these are to be shelter inside the brood pouch inside this chamber, and it is the good example as a parental care which is to be found in male hippocampus, whereas it is to be absent in female hippocampus. Hence this brood pouch is act as a sexual dimorphic character, as well as it is to be act as a parental care. It is showing the advanced condition of parental care in this hippocampus species or the seahorse species. Everywhere it is to be look like a famous example. Again, it is to be commonly called as seahorse. Why it is to be called as commonly seahorse? Because this fish, these are to be look like a horse-like appearance. Here has head, this fish head is to be look like a horse-like appearance, hence it is called as the seahorse. See, this is the, depending upon the brood pouch, we can identify the male hippocampus and female hippocampus, which is to be shown in the figure. See, this is the head, which is to look like a horse-like structure. This structure, these are to be found, and this structure, these, hence it is called as male hippocampus and female hippocampus. This is the first figure, it is the female hippocampus where brood pouch is not present. But in second figure, here is a brood pouch is present, where I have coated in a red color, or better it is to be coated into a green coloration. Yes, green color these I have peeled in this, and this brood pouch, these are to be bag-like structure, sac-like structure, which is to present in the abdomen. And in this brood pouch, in this sac, in this bag, female these are to be deposit egg, and then eggs these are to be incubate, and spawn these are to produce, and these spawn they can shelter inside the brood chamber, inside the brood pouch. And a advanced structure of parental care, as well as advanced structure of, that is the sexual dimorphism seen in this fish, that is the sexual dimorphic character which is to be seen in hippocampus. Sexual dimorphic character, sexual dimorphism is to be found on the seahorse, a best example, a good example seen. Yes, again this is a fish sexual dimorphic character in the hippocampus. See, first here is a female fish, green color, then red color. This is the male fish where brood pouch, these are to be covered in red. Then in another figure, again a blue color. Here is a female, these are to be shown, no brood pouch these are to be found, no brood pouch these are to be occur. But again in another figure, here is a black coloring, a brood pouch is to be seen, a brood pouch is found. Means these are the different fishes. These are to be look like a horse-like appearance. These are to be swimming in a such manner that these are to be swimming in undulating conditions in water, and it is to look like a horse-like appearance. Hence, this fish is called as a seahorse, and scientific name of this fish is the hippocampus. Male hippocampus possesses a brood pouch, possesses a chamber, possesses a pouch bag chamber, and this pouch bag chamber, these are to be used to shelter and incubate the eggs and offspring, and after the offspring, these are to be larger in size, increase larger in size, then they can free from their parents. A good parental care example, these are to be seen. Parental care example, these are to be found in sexual dimorphic character. That is a good example, best example is to be seen. Then another important fish, another teleost fish. The dorsal fin of the male Molinicea fish is enlarged to form a cell-like structure. Another teleost, dorsal fin of the male Molinicea fish is enlarged to form a cell-like structure and has brilliantly colored ocelli. Brilliantly colored ocelli is to present on this Molinicea fish shell-like structure, which is absent in female Molinicea fish. And this structure, these are to be identified whether the fish is to be male Molinicea or whether the fish is to be female Molinicea. In female, such brilliantly colored cell-like structure, these are to be absent, these are to be not found in female fish, whereas in a dorsal fin of male Molinicea fish, such cell-like brilliantly colored structure, ocelli, these are to present, these are to be found in male Molinicea. This is the sexual dimorphic character. Another example, in next, male bowfin Amaya. Again, male bowfin Amaya has a large black spot, is present at the base of the caudal fin. Large black spot is to present at the base of the caudal fin, and such black spot is to be absent in female Amaya fish, which is to be showing below. Yes, this is the fish Amaya, and this a large spot. Just to present, this large spot is to be a black spot is to present, and this black spot is to present at the base of the caudal fin, and such black spot is to be absent in female fish. Means depending on this black spot, we can identify bowfin Amaya is either male Amaya or either female Amaya. Again, this bowfin Amaya is also a good example for parental care. We have seen in detail in parental care, that is, this fish is a famous example as a sexual dimorphic character as well as a parental care. The black spot is to be only present, only found at the base of the caudal peduncle. In male fish, such black spot is to be absent in female fish. This is to be seen. See, sexual dimorphism in male and female Amaya fish. Which is the male and female Amaya fish? Upper fish, where a black spot is to be present, where a black spot is to be found at the base of this caudal fin, that fish is called as male Amaya. Whereas in lower fish, such black spot is to be not present, such black spot is to be not found, that fish is called as the female Amaya. And this is the sexual dimorphic character. Means all these examples, it indicate that, all these examples, it is to be noted that in fishes also, we can identify, we can recognize depending on structure related to copulation as well as structure related to not for copulation. But there is a difference, these are to be found in male fish and female fish. These structure, as in lionhead chitrid fish, these structure, these are to be found in Mr. Singhala, these structure, these are to be found in guppy fish, structure, these are to be found in, that is, Gypophorus hilary, structure, these are to be found in Molinicea, structure, these are to be found in, that is, the hippocampus or Amaya. All these examples, it indicate that in fishes also sexual dimorphism is to be seen, and we can identify whether the fish is male or whether the fish is to be female. These structure easily identified fish is male and fish is female. With this, we have completed the article, that is sexual dimorphism in fishes. We can identify, we can recognize whether fish is male fish or whether fish is to be female fish. Here we have seen the points and complete the our article. Hope you understand and recognize very well. Thank you, all of you.